Hi, and welcome back to the channel. I would like to talk briefly about removing the DC offset from digital microphones. So digital microphones, they give you a stream which contains the audio signal after a little bit of processing. But most of those microphones, they are not perfect. They will have a slight DC offset. Now that DC offset might be harmless for some application, but in other application it can be very, very annoying. Now in analog world, it's very, very easy, right? In analog world, what we do, insert a series capacitor, which is going to block all the DC component. Obviously we can't do this in a digital domain. It's a little bit more complicated. But how we do this in the digital domain? So first of all, I'll show you the block diagram of my Vivado design. So this part is responsible for the microphone, so low pass filtering with the CIC decimator. I'm not going to focus on this because I made another video about this. So this is the block that I added to remove the DC offset in order to clean the DC offset from my stream. Now my actual hardware, the DC offset, it was quite significant. So how I implemented this, I wrote this block in VHDL, so, and I packaged it as an IP, so I can use it later in other design. Okay, so how I implemented it. It's a document on the internet written by Xilinx, by Ken Chapman, Xilinx man. He described here a method of removing the DC offset. Oh, this is a signal with the DC offset, right? In red are the samples, the discrete samples. You see there is a slight positive shift here. So if we know the offset, right, we can subtract it from the samples because those are just a string of numbers, positive and negative numbers. So if we know the offset, in this case it's 19, we can just subtract it with a simple subtractor, a signed subtractor. Why I say sign? The offset can be negative as well, and the samples are positive and negative, and this has to be a signed subtractor. Okay, so now I'm going to skip. There are a few methods here which they involve multipliers and a bunch of other things, but I'm going to skip because the document is actually getting to a point where things are very, very simple. They simplify a lot. Now, this is what I implemented. So what we need, this is the block that you've seen previously, which is removing the offset. So the offset is here, it's somehow calculated by this and is getting removed by this subtractor. I'm saying again, this subtractor is actually a signed subtractor because the offset can be negative as well. And the same thing with the samples. The samples, they are positive and negative. So this is a signed subtractor. Now, this example is for 8-bit wide samples. As you can see here, this block, which is the actual block which calculates the DC offset, it's much wider. So this is a 16-bit wide block. Now, what this means, this representation, it means that this is sine extended to 16-bit. So your 8-bit sample, they're actually getting sine extended in this adder, and then it's a register. So what this block actually is, it's an accumulator. What is an accumulator? It keeps adding all the samples which they come. So the samples they come in, they might be positive or negative, and they keep added, and this is the output of the register, so it's adding to the next sample, to the next. So this is a 16-bit accumulator, right? And by adding all the samples together, eventually you will fall on the, or they will add together on the DC offset. So imagine that you have a sinusoid which has no DC offset. So you have positive samples and negative samples. If you add them together over a few periods, they will add to zero because the positive, they will cancel the negative ones. So they will eventually, the accumulator will settle around zero, right? Over a long period of time. Now, if your sample, you have more positive samples than negative samples, of course, the accumulated value here will settle to that positive. The same thing with negative. So you will have the offset actually here in this register. Now, what this is actually splitting the most significant bits and least significant bits. So the least significant bits, they will be fractional bits. and those are the most significant. So basically this branch of 8 bits, 8 MSBs, becomes the DC level, which is getting calculated on the fly based on the input samples, right? And this is getting subtracted by this block. So if we tap here, before we sign extend to this 16-bit, if we tap here, we will actually have the corrected signal. The input samples with the DC offset removed by the subtractor, right? So this is the principle, works like a charm. I simulated, works perfectly in simulation. I put it on the board in hardware, works fantastic. Now, my block, going back a little bit to the Vivado, my block, actually I implemented a block with parameters, so you can choose the width of the sample, because my samples are 16-bit. So when you choose here, it will actually parameterize the block. So if we change this to 8, it will be exactly like the one in the example. So now I have this block that which I can use further down, and I can use it in other other designs. I'll try to publish the code on my blog when I have time. And this is it. And thank you very much for watching.